Welcome back, you guys. We are out here on Lake Pleasant. We are here with the Peoria Fire Department. This is their brand new boat that they are showing off here that is stationed at Lake Pleasant. And I want to introduce you to the public information officer with Peoria Fire, Mark Barbie. Let's talk about this piece of equipment because this thing is pretty incredible.
It is. So what we're showing you right now is we have a deck cannon, or some people call it a water gun, that can flow up to 1,000 gallons per minute. What that allows us to do is to reach fire a great distance. If maybe one or more boats were on fire at the marina, it would keep us safe and also put the water out, or put the fire out more quickly to protect the people.
Mark, let's talk about this too, because this boat, you said, was specifically designed for rescue type operations. Look at the front here, you guys, because this can kind of come down. You guys can beach this boat, so to speak, so that you can get if there's some sort of incident on land, right?
Yeah, so in our last boat, what we would have to do is somebody would have to jump off and actually hold a rope to keep the boat away from the shore, and then that would limit, we would only have three people to go help the person that needed. This one we can actually beach. It's an aluminum hull, so we can actually drive it up onto land, lower the bow, and we can put up to 2,000 pounds on that. We can pull patients up on there as needed.
And you said this perfect was too, because if there is some sort of emergency situation, you can put the patients right here where we're standing, be able to work on them with the emergency personnel here to get them the safe, or the help that they need.
That's correct. So the last boat, even if we were to put one patient here, it was hard to walk around them. We were constantly stepping over them. This one, we can put two patients side by side. We have a full complement of gear out here, so we can provide medicine, IVs, any kind of trauma care. This is just like any other fire apparatus with two paramedics and two EMTs.
Mark, we've got about a minute left, but what type of injuries or issues are you guys seeing out here on the lake?
So believe it or not, a lot of them are cuts, broken bones. Right now with the heat, the last few days has been heat related. But 4th of July, we're expecting all that to pick up, and you know, we'll see a lot of different injuries.
Sure. You said this boat's pretty fast too, right?
With four people on it, it'll do 47 miles an hour, which is very fast on the water, and we can take on an additional 12 people if needed.
Wow. Let's talk real quick. How many people do you have that man this boat, so to speak?
So we're out here for 48 hours, and during that 48 hours, there's a four-person crew that operates this. They're all rescue swimmer and boat operators.
Very cool. All right, so we're going to come back here, you guys, in just a few minutes. We're going to do a simulated rescue to show you exactly what they do when there is some sort of emergency situation. So that's coming up on the other side of the break. We'll be right back.
Ty looks ready for something.
Oh, yeah.
Something big.
On that new Peoria fireboat out there at Lake Pleasant.
You look official.
Yeah, this is so cool, you guys. This is a brand new boat. So this is, we're going to set the scene for you. Take a look. We've got the guy in the water. He's a firefighter. He's not really in trouble, but he is going to be our victim here. So they are going to show us kind of what they do when they come across this. And we were just talking, you guys had a rescue very similar to this just last night.
Just last night, yeah. We did have an injury out here where the rescue swimmers had to get in the water and help somebody out.
So walk me through what's happening right now. We got the rescue swimmers that are actually jumping into the water.
That's correct. We have rescue swimmer one and rescue swimmer two. They're going to go after him, give him instructions when they get close to him, if he's combative or scared or something like that. Then they're going to hand him that flotation device that's called a Peterson belt. So they're going to grab that. The first rescuer has captured him. They give some hand cues to let him know everybody's okay. And then the captain, who's still on the boat, will grab the rope and pull them back. Now, what's great about this boat is because the front of it folds down like a ramp, it's going to be much easier to get them up into the boat after the rescue. So now we can have another firefighter come up. They'll help. They'll get them on there. We can pull them up onto the deck of the boat and assess them here.
Mark, I see him wearing the microphone, the headphones
yep.
there. He's in constant communication with the captain of the boat, right?
They can all hear each other. It's just a way to communicate without having to yell. When you yell across the water, it can be very loud.
Now, we see him on the backboard. Is that common procedure that you always put, no matter what type of injury, what type of victim it is, you always put the backboard on them?
Yeah. So again, that doesn't we're not necessarily worried about their spinal injury at this point. That's going to help us get them out of the water. But the added bonus is if they did have any kind of compromised spinal injury, that would help
mitigate it. Now, so in a regular situation, you guys would close this up and then get underway, right, and try and get back to shore? What would be the kind of the protocol after that?
So the captain here wearing the red headset, he's the one kind of running the show. He's going to be the one kind of saying, hey, we need to do this. He happens to be one of the two paramedics on this fireboat. So they're assessing the patient right now and making a decision on what part of the lake they're going to go to. It depends on where he told the rescue or the ambulance to go. So if he said, hey, rescue 195, go to Pleasant Harbor Marina North Ramp, then that's where he would expect they would be, and that's where we would be going to right now. So now, they'll coordinate all that.
In this particular situation, we're pretending he has a leg injury, but I mean, you guys can run the gamut as far as calls are concerned out here, from broken bones to
chest pain,
drownings, heat stroke. I mean, you guys have to be prepared for something like this. Talk about the training that goes in, and then talk about how specifically do you have to do anything special to be on a boat.
So, yes, again, these guys are all, the crew here are all rescue swimmer boat operators, so there's an intense course to get that certification, and then they have 20 hours a month of continuing education just for that particular certification. Now, that does not include the paramedic and EMT continuing education hours, so they're ready for anything out here that, a traditional fire truck would be ready for. All the gear, any call, you name it, they can handle it.
That is pretty incredible. You guys all have to kind of do this while moving on a boat in sometimes choppy water, inclement weather. I mean, it's pretty incredible what these guys are able to do.
It is. They're great. They train together quite a bit, and practice makes perfect.
Yeah. So that's what I was going to ask you, too. How often are you guys running through scenarios like this and practicing out here on the open water?
So weekly, there's a designated day every week that they're mandated to train. So it's there's certain things that they need to be training on. And the crews are great about that, and that's just part of the continuing education. So if it's not once a week, a lot of the crews do it more often.
So in this particular scenario, now that we've got him secured, he's safe, now do you guys radio ahead and say, hey, we're coming in, get an ambulance or whatever you might need ready?
So the crews with the wireless headset on, they are using a radio to communicate with other incoming crews, specifically the rescue, or if there's another command coming in, if this is a larger situation, they can communicate back and forth.
Now, when we mentioned that he's in this situation, he has just a leg injury, but I mean, we see him kind of hooked up to is that an EKG? I don't know my terminology.
It's a heart monitor. That's going to allow us to monitor blood pressure, heart rate, his oxygen saturation. Well, the other questions they would be asking him is how much pain you're in. They would be doing a secondary on him, looking at him from head to toe for any other obvious injuries, and then questioning him about what maybe he's experiencing that they don't see.
Let's talk about switching gears here. You were saying, you know, you come up on someone that may have fallen off of a paddleboard. They might not have their life preserver on or something like that. You were saying that I never realized this, but you guys have to really, I mean, obviously you're moving, they're moving. Talk about how you make sure that you're going right to where that victim potentially is.
So Peoria Fire Medical is going to suggest that anybody comes to the lake, they should have a PFD, a flotation device, on all the time. But quite a few times the people who get themselves in situations aren't wearing these. So if you're out here paddleboarding, kayaking, and you're thrown from your device, we would suggest that you try and swim toward your device and use that as a flotation device before calling for help. The farther that gets away, it's going to take more effort to get
sure.
to it.
But you were saying that, you know, you might have to go rescue them, but you always keep this on. You're not going to take this off. Mm-hmm. So you're fighting against the best to actually go down and potentially rescue these victims.
Yeah, that's just part of the training. So not just the PFD, but in colder seasons, they're wearing a full suit that also makes them buoyant. So if you have that full suit on plus the vest, it takes quite a bit of strength and endurance to be able to do that. And especially if you know where somebody went and now you have to dive and fight,
awesome.
Being able to go underwater.
Well, Mark, Captain Mark Barbie with Peoria Fire Department, thank you so much for letting us come out. Give him a round of applause for his Oscar award-winning performance here of the victim out here on Lake Pleasant. Pretty cool stuff. We'll send it back into you guys.
He looks good. Hey, I got quick questions for you, Ty. How much does a boat like
sure.
this fully outfitted cost? Because it's an amazing piece of machinery.
So this boat is upwards of $300,000.
Mm. Oh, wow.
Not cheap.
And then your personal flotation devices. I've never seen one like that. It almost looks like it's a combination, like a bulletproof vest or something. It's so streamlined, so they can work in it.
It is very streamlined. Yeah, he's got there's different chambers. It's got the CO2. You can turn around, and we've got the, what else is on here?
We got a handle here to pull them up out of the water.
Oh, yeah.
Pull up out of the water. We have a strobe. If you fall in the water at night, we can see where you're at. That's activated. And then you have this straw that you can blow more air into if you're find yourself sinking.
That's pretty fancy schmick.
They got all the best out here in Peoria.
Yes, they do.
All the best.
So are they the lead law enforcement agency out there? Because I know MCSO also patrols the lake. But it's Peoria's water, right?
Yep. Peoria is doing law enforcement. They also, you know, assist. But then Peoria is mainly doing all of the rescue operations out here. If there's, you know, as you mentioned, a potential drowning, or if there's a fire or whatever, they're out here as well.
I tell you what,
it's pretty amazing.
That was pretty neat.
Yeah.